Hey, what's up, everybody? In this series, we're going to be taking a look at game making with Construct 2. This is going to be a beginner-level series for someone who knows nothing about game making or Construct 2, or someone who knows a bit about Construct but would like to better understand each of the behaviors that are available for an object in Construct. I'm not going to be making a whole game just yet. Here we're going to be going through each of the behaviors that Construct has available and look at some examples of how they work. So, just to get the basics out of the way, in Construct 2, every item you see on the screen is called an object. If we took Super Mario Bros. As an example, you have the Mario character, which would be an object. Then, you have the blocks, which would be another object. Then the Koopas would be another object, and so on. Each item in the game is its own object. We'll talk about it more in the future, but there are also some non-visible objects as well, things like audio playback, or to receive input from the keyboard. In Construct, these objects can have behaviors applied to them. A behavior adds prepackaged functionality to an object. For example, there's a behavior called 8Direction, which allows you to easily let an object be controllable by the player. There's a behavior called Fade, which can be used to cause an enemy to fade out after they are killed. Instead of coding that functionality, all you need to do is add the Fade behavior and activate it when the enemy is killed. Behaviors allow you to add functionality quickly, without writing any code, and they are customizable with parameters that alter the way the behavior affects the object. Let's take a look. Here I have a blank project open, and I'm going to add an object. To add an object to a Construct 2 project, just double-click anywhere on the layout. That brings up this Insert New Object window, where we can choose the type of object that we want to use. Most of the behaviors that we have access to in Construct will be affecting an object known as a sprite. A sprite is an animatable image that appears in the game. Players, enemies, projectiles, explosions, and non-tiling scenery would all be examples of a sprite object. Click on Sprite under General, and then click on Insert to add the sprite object to the project. After you press Insert, the cursor changes to a plus sign. Click anywhere in the layout to place the sprite at that location. That brings up this Edit Image window, where we can load up an image for our sprite. To load an image, click the folder icon, Load an Image from a File. I have a sprite here that I'd like to use, so I'll select that, and go ahead and close down the Edit Image window. Now, we have our sprite added to the project. I'd like to give it a name, though. So under Object Type Properties, I'll change the name to Player. We'll go in depth on these behaviors later in the series, but just so you get an idea of what a behavior is and how easy it is to use them in Construct 2, I'll go ahead and show you a couple of them now. To add a behavior to an object, first you need to select the object by clicking on it once. Then, on the left side of the screen, in the Properties panel, there's a section called Behaviors. With the object that you want to add a behavior to selected, click on the blue Behaviors link. That brings up the Behaviors window, where we can add or delete any behaviors from our object. To add a new behavior to the player, select the Add New icon, which looks like a plus sign. That brings up the Add Behavior window. From here, we can see all of the behaviors that are available for this object type. Notice there are different categories of behaviors. We have attributes, general, and movement. Let's try something from the movement category. I'll go with rotate. Just double-click the behavior you want to add. Now, the player object has the rotate behavior applied to it. Rotate does just what it says. It rotates the sprite around its origin point. If I preview the layout, you can see the player object rotating around. Let's add another behavior. Click on Behaviors, and then Add New. This time I'll choose Physics. Physics will cause this object to have gravity applied to it. If I preview the layout, the player is spinning, and he falls off the screen. That's all there is to adding behaviors to objects. Select the object, bring up the Behaviors window, hit Add Behavior, and select the behavior you want. After that, you can edit the parameters of the behavior to alter the way the object behaves during gameplay. For example, we can change the speed the player rotates. This is why Construct 2 is so powerful, and why it is so easy to make games with it. In the rest of this series, we'll take a look at each behavior that is available in Construct 2 and how to use them. By the end of this series, you'll have a full understanding of the behaviors and what can be done with them. Thanks for watching. Please comment, like, and share this video, and subscribe for more content. See you next time.